Hi guys, this is Emnel and we are back playing Hearthstone 4 as France. If we take a look here, you will see how well we are actually doing, since we pretty much cleaned up all the packets we had, save like a few divisions trapped in Caucasus area. Soviet Union is down to around 100 bloody divisions. That's almost, yeah, that's basically half of what us, Poland and Romania have combined. On top of that, they lost almost 3 million men, while our casualties are under 200,000, so, yep, doing well. I also noticed that actually Czechs decided that, they don't feel like it, and when I wasn't looking, they apparently right after arriving to the front line went back home and are camping along the Hungarian and German borders. So there's that. Seems like there is an option for, seems like there's a chance for some encirclements here, so let's see. Oh, can we, well, those are very weak divisions. So let's continue this attack. This unit should probably try to push forward a little bit, and well, we should close this small pocket, which will of course result in various problems, because our front lines will be cut like this. But yeah, those six divisions should definitely attack. Wow, it's a lot of movement. There we go. And that should do it. For this, they should be able to regroup later. Should we capture this? Probably not. Do I push from here up north, perhaps? Like a quick ride. Let's get two panzers and give it a go. We probably won't be able to escape all the mud anyway, but well, might as well try. Of course, that means that we need to, where are they? That was Control H, was it? Yes. Unassign them from this order, and the rest can pretty much stay as it is. This is going to be a very minor, and so, well, I guess that there should be about 20 divisions here, perhaps a little less. Not the worst. Something like that. As for Leningrad, we'll get to it later. We'll probably do a push towards Arkhangelsk here or something, and then just clear out this whole area, including Leningrad. I could try naval landing, but the problem is that Leningrad, yes, it does have 5 coastal ports. We'd have to risk landing pretty much next to it and hoping for the best in terms of getting a port. So, probably not only not worth a hassle, but a dangerous hassle that would be. And besides that, we should be able to more or less steadily push forwards. Last thing about it, I think we won't stop our push, we won't do any massive offenses, not that we need to, beyond those few things, such as this incursion with panzers, we'll just continue pushing throughout the mad season, since we are we do have enough equipment that well, I don't think that our allies are in a dire need of equipment either. Well, they seem fairly capable, and their strength is at full or almost full, so I think we're good there. Oh, right, I forgot we, however, want to start building those medium tanks, I guess. Let's see. The problem with them is that they have speed of 8, so if you want them to be fast enough, well, powerful. I'm not sure actually if we want to go for the main gun or for armor. Let's say that armor would probably be the better option. Speed stays as it is, so it will match mechanized troops if we are so inclined. So say we'll go with armor. It's a bit slow reliability, 1 heart, so let's start building those. We could request some territory easily from our allies. Not sure if we want to do. Let's see how the... So save the territories that are left behind. We are doing pretty well in terms of fighting resistance, simply because we have so many troops around. So attrition is pretty bad here. And they really should go and redeploy stuff. There you go. That's good enough. Almost in Moscow. I guess let's get some territory from both Poland and Romania. Let's get Kaluga. Oh, we can do just that. Well, that will do for starters. This one is Romanian though. Damn it. Oh, here we go. That's cool. This one is, that's good. Let's leave them Vitebsk and Minsk, Ravensk, yeah, something like that. The front run, really. Sadly, that's, we're not in control of those, so that will pretty much mean a constant mess. Expeditionary, no, I don't want to, I could take those as expeditionary forces now when I think about it. Which is weird that they haven't offered until now. Well, they are not using them, so might as well. Send them to this guy. Okay, let's check what kind of divisions are we talking here. Are those really our divisions? I mean, those really are our, what this division is doing here, I cannot comprehend. Where which? Never mind. Let's check those. Could have been better, and Romania can keep theirs. Alright. To be honest, I'm not 100% sure who pays in terms of manpower for expeditionary forces. I rarely use them. And well, in terms of equipment, well, I'll have to do some testing. Well, that got shut down pretty fast. Let's do it wide. Actually, let's go here. How are you doing? You are going this way. Good. So you will be going this, something like that. More or less, and we definitely need to capture this whole area. It's a lot of mud, but I think we can spare a tank or two. Yeah, and that resulted in one of our surgically redeploying units being stopped, and well, they're assigned there too, so let's reassign them back in. We could of course rush here, but that seems excessive in terms of cutting the front line. Let's try to push through here. Yeah, they seem fairly weak. Here we could go like that, I guess. Well, just easy. Like this. It's an excessive amount of power in a way. Amount of micro such it will mess up our fronts, but yeah, it's a force of habit really. Okay, you stay there for the time being, since how big yeah, so our losses are getting pretty high fighting in those in this terrain. It's okay though. Unless we have no other enemy we could fight. I mean, we could fight Japan, but that's kind of pointless, because it will be just, you know, we will fairly easily, I believe. Yes, very easily kick them out of China. And then we'll just need to wait for the longest time to get the island. So we'll just defeat Soviet Union and give it a go and finish it, unless, you know, there will be an overwhelming insistence to continue, then, well, might as well, it won't take that long, but I'm not sure if that will be that interesting. Okay, you guys can simply go this way, cut them off. Oh, look at that. I'm really not sure what those Portuguese troops are doing here. It's been going for a while. You guys should definitely go like this. So this attack. Alright, so we managed to more or less secure this encirclement. Should do alright, that those units should get there in time, and what they are attacking us with. Well, those Portuguese troops, but yeah, they are in no position to fight. Alright, yeah. Worked fine enough. We can collapse on this again. Here I would actually cut this and finish it off. What are we doing here? Oh, this one division got stuck, so let's assign her there. And somehow half of our green divisions got unassigned from this order. It's only 11 here. This one is pushing. It's asking to be cut off, really. Do we have enough? More or less. I guess we can keep going. Should be alright. So the three divisions are here. And I imagine there is another front line here that isn't showing. And that's why they're... Yeah, that makes sense, because otherwise this unit would move there, and it's not unassigned from other. There would be a red exclamation mark if it wasn't assigned to any front line. So this is just not showing. It's fairly rare, but a bug that I've seen earlier. Do I care about those tanks? I'll just leave them be and to do their thing, and use them if need be, if there is an option for a powerful breakthrough. But I think we'll just wait for that mud to go away. It seems to be drying up around here, and yeah, it's the end of April, so one more month and we should be good. Our allies are slowly but surely capturing all of the Caucasus. And yes, we are collapsing on that as well. If you're going there. Alright, because you got stopped in a way. Moscow is about to fall. We go there. We can go in this direction. Communist in government. The communist movement in France, fueled by broad dissatisfaction among the working class and radical trends among academics, has grown large enough to lead the formation of several parties. After one of these has gained considerable support in the current election, politicians in Parti Radicale have started debating whether or not to seek their support in forming a government, although they consider our democratic institution to be little more than a bourgeois tyranny, and they seem eager to make the changes they want to see through cooperating with the government rather than overthrowing it. Right, so they're basically socialists now. But reformed an evolution. Yes, we'll accept that. No. No point in investing further into this. Let's try not 2 years ahead of time. So what are we working on? We are... Alright, yes, ground assault. We are working. For a second I couldn't see it. I guess some planes would be in order. Let's go with better, closer support. Because on other counts I think we are covered. Just one more look. How are we on infantry? Alright, so we could actually get improved infantry equipment. I'd say that tanks or planes are more important now. We are good on the on our infantry for the time being. Alright, so all of that is going fairly well. We aren't defeating that many, but it's definitely a few divisions here, a few divisions there. And we are advancing fairly rapidly in all directions. our ally is not far behind, or sometimes quite far behind. Now you should get back to the main order. Oh, that's probably because, yeah. Infrastructure. Oh, we simply need to get those provinces to free it up. It shouldn't take long. Let's move them like this. Very well. I think I will keep asking for some land. Can we? Okay, who controls this? Well, apparently we do. Sure doesn't look like it. Romania. It doesn't matter. There will be a peace conference soon enough and we'll cover that. Alright. After a series of pitched battles, not really, Allied forces have occupied Moscow, capital of the Soviet Union. The city has suffered extensive damage and fires are still raging on both sides of the Moskva River. And despite heavy bombing, the Kremlin is reasonably intact and it has been chosen as the location for the headquarters of Allied Occupation Administration. I'm pretty sure we aren't in allies last time I checked. The loss of Moscow. So why isn't no event for a French conquest of Moscow? What's up with that? The loss of Moscow, the Soviet war effort, has suffered an enormous blow, although most of the government is believed to have evacuated the city well in advance of its fall. Military experts claim that complete Soviet collapse may not be far away. Sadly, they employed the bloody Kalinin, boosting the national unity to 90, which will make the collapse not as imminent as you would hope. They are still suffering very heavy casualties, and there are definitely no position to basically cover all the fronts. I think that our next, we should move our mobile troops up north, I think. All of them. And we'll redo that push up north. And we'll do it manually, I'd say. Probably with our motorized troops too. That's why not. Motorized will go from this angle in a similar fashion. Here we go. Let's remove those old ones. So this is problematic actually those are here. The second I thought this front line wasn't there, and I guess the other one isn't. Oh, it's here. But there should be a yellow front line around here, assuming it's not invisible. How's this going? So we are only once attacking. Those are, for some reason, they are doing pretty damn well. Now let's redraw our attack lines. Doesn't really have to go from there. I don't want to cut this front line in half, not really. Okay, let's get this and simply move you there. We will also, there is that yellow front line. I knew it. Move it here. Not this. Move it there. Now. we'd simply reassign our units back in, order them to attack. Now, those units. Don't want them to simply. Why are you here? Definitely should be. All right. There are supply problems here again. Fair enough. Oh, this is a terrible attack. How about you go ahead and attack there? Cut it off and do that before until we finish there. This attack, Japanese and Polish forces against, some tanks even. Let's throw one of those divisions here as a support. They can move to their proper positions later. That should be enough to clean this packet up. How are we on the butcher count? Butcher's bill. 3.2. Alright, it's starting to look more and more green the way I like it. Let's help here. There we go, that should do it. You guys should definitely start attacking up north from here. Please start moving. Right, but we'll need that redeployment to finish if we wanted to somehow go. Okay, so our tanks are already here. Mud is still present, so I guess we'll need to wait till the end of May or so. Is it raining? Not really, just post-winter mud. It's mostly clear around here, through those forests. Probably this is that one. Those are bloody forests, and driving through a forest with motorized troops is a pain in the ass to begin with, but well, might as well. So two of them will go like this, and the other two will go a bit wider. And here, actually, we're going to cross in this direction and go like that. Something like it. That seems to map, or whatever. We should be able to. I don't think there will be much in terms of resistance up there left, so it doesn't have to be ideal. Now, is it, yeah, actually it's raining here and there. Well, we'll leave them where they are for now, and then perhaps we'll just strategically deploy them up north. If, this mud still holds. Yeah, let's continue. Going for planes, in case we ever want to actually use them. How is the plane situation? Well, it seems like we are winning for some reason. How are you guys playing? So you still have 3k, but I don't know, are you running out of, not sure what can you run out of, and why there are, well, you have, I guess, strategic bombers around Czechoslovakia, but that's about it, 50 of those. Interesting. Is there really no Soviet air action anywhere? Apparently 500 are there, even though they are not showing up on the map. Okay, now they showed. Yeah, so it's maybe just a redeployment. That will slow our push here considerably. Bloody Xingang troops. How many troops do they have? It's really excessive. Still mad. Okay, well, our infantry should follow up. Yeah, we are cleaning those up. Very nice. Yeah, that should do it. This one. Oh, they're holding steady. Well, we have three divisions that we can use here, so I'm not sure why we aren't. Well, I know why, because, well, we have no supply. Well, this is not going to get bad. No, actually, we control only under 80% of Edge provinces, so as soon as we get those, this one and this one, it should get a bit better. And what saddens me is the fact that we have not gotten a pop-up, an event for a conquest of Stalingrad, which is a bit weird. We'll see if we will get for a Leningrad. Maybe it just fizzled out in a way. That being said, we are out of time. So thanks for watching, guys. In the meantime, I think I will take some of the Romanian territory for myself. Between the episodes, and then we will continue our conquest of Soviet Union and see how well we I'd say we should be able to conquer them by the end of the year at least. It's of course a bit slower with manual control, with automatic control and such, but yeah, it would be a lot of things to control by hand. And as you can see, most of our troops are keeping their regular status and actually gaining experience. How are the tanks? Pretty good. Actually, I haven't done that much in terms of actual attritional fighting, hence the those levels aren't as high as you might have expected after conquering almost all of Europe. So, yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Have a nice day and see you tomorrow.